Hi, and welcome to Gas Density and the Ideal Gas Law, PV equals nRT, in which we will look at what gas density refers to, mathematically incorporating density into PV equals nRT, and then a couple of practice problems with density and PV equals nRT. So like any density, gas density is the ratio of its mass to volume, and gases occupy their entire container, so its density is the mass of the gas divided by the container's volume. Let's make this helium, and we can see how density would change by comparison to other gases such as oxygen. Note that from the periodic table, we see that the helium to oxygen mass ratio is 4 to 32, but this ratio only holds if comparing the same number of particles, which is the case here, but having the same amount of particles can be assumed from Avogadro's hypothesis that any two gases at the same pressure, temperature, and volume will have the same number of particles. Both illustrations have the same number of particles in the same volume, but the periodic table mass of the oxygen molecule is 8 times the mass of the helium atom, and so the density of oxygen will be 8-fold higher. Let's go back to our 10 atoms of helium. What would happen if we increased the amount of helium atoms but keep the volume constant? Our example here of 20 atoms versus 10 means the second mass is twice the first mass, and so the density is doubled as well, assuming the same volume for each. Okay, now that we know what gas density is, how does it fit mathematically into the ideal gas law, PV equals nRT? For reference, let's keep all of our variables and constants defined on the side here, and some of the common units used in chemistry are shown as well. Let's take PV equals nRT and isolate volume, since that is the denominator in density, which is mass over volume. Dividing both sides by pressure allows us to cancel pressure on the left, and we then have the equation rearranged in terms of volume, V. We know that density is mass divided by volume, in this case gas volume, so if we divide mass by volume on the left, that gives density. But we would then have to divide the right side into mass to keep things equal. Pressure is now in the denominator of a denominator, and so comes to the numerator. Density is mass times pressure divided by nRT. This presents something very interesting because mass over moles is molar mass. And we can then substitute molar mass for mass over n in the equation to get density equals molar mass times pressure divided by RT. We now have two equations expressing the ideal gas law in terms of density. Let's see how we can use information in a problem to determine which equation to use. Let's do two problems. The first gives us pressure and temperature, but neither mass nor molar mass. However, we do have the identity of the gas, carbon dioxide, and so from the periodic table, we find the molar mass to be 44 grams per mole. Since we now have molar mass, we can see the second equation would be appropriate. Plugging in the values from the problem as well as using the gas constant with the appropriate units, in this case liters since we want the gas density to be expressed with liters, and kilopascals is the unit in the problem, while Kelvin has to be used since the gas constant relies on absolute temperature, and moles is the common way to express the amount of gas particles in chemistry, we see that Kelvin cancels, kilopascals cancels, and moles cancel, which leaves grams over liters, which is mass over volume, which is density. If your units do not cancel correctly, then you have set up the problem incorrectly. The density of carbon dioxide under the given conditions is 1.32 grams per liter. Last problem. Here we are given moles, density, pressure, and temperature. The question is asking for mass, so we will use the first equation. Let's rearrange the equation to isolate mass and then plug in the given values. If we multiply both sides by nRT over P, then nRT and P cancel on the right, leaving mass by itself. Let's plug everything in, and this time we use R with ATM since that is the unit used in the problem. Atmospheres, Kelvin, moles, and liters all cancel, leaving grams, the unit for mass. Plugging everything in gives a mass of 20.2 grams. The second question asks what gas this is. Well, we have mass and we have moles. If we divide the two, that gives us the molar mass of the gas. Let's look on the periodic table and we see that argon matches our calculated molar mass. And so it seems this is argon.